In this session, we are going to discuss the second method of cache mapping, that is the associative mapping. This associative mapping can also be called as fully associative mapping. So we are going to do the same, that means we are going to do this fully associative mapping on the same problem. So this is the problem. We are having 4096 number of pages in the main memory. So 4096 number of pages in the main memory, and as we are starting from 0, so that's why my last page number is 4095. Good. So how many bits are there to denote the page number? 12 bits. For each and every page, how many locations are there? 16. How many bits will be required to denote the offset in that case? 4. So how many bits will be required in the main memory address? 16. How many frames are there? 128. How many bits will be required to represent the frame number? 7. Page size is equal to the frame size, yes or no? Yes. So how many locations in the per frame? 16. So how many bits will be there for the frame offset? 4. So this is the problem on which we are going to do. Now in this case, we are going to introduce a new type of memory known as a CAM. The full form of CAM is content addressable memory. Content addressable memory. This content addressable memory is playing a very vital role in case of associative mapping or fully associative mapping. Now, unlike direct mapping, here main memory, any page can be loaded onto the cache memory, any frame. Main memory, any page can be loaded onto the cache memory, any frame. That is the flexibility we are enjoying. So what will happen? We are having 12-bit main memory page number. We are having 4 bits main memory page offset. In CAM, these 12 bits will be searched. I think I'm not clear. Let us suppose I'm searching that where the page number 2000 has got loaded onto the cache memory. Then 2000 is here. This 2000 will be searched in the CAM mode. In the CAM, so many locations are there containing the page number and respective frame number. Page number, respective frame number. In this way, CAM is having so many locations. The most peculiarity in searching in CAM is that CAM will allow parallel searching. That means if I ask that page number 2000 has got loaded onto the which cache frame, then 2000 will be searched in all locations of the CAM at the same time. So very fast searching. So after getting the required pair, it will get the required cache frame number, and that will be of 7 bits. So this 7 bits will be coming, and this particular 4 bits will be coming as the frame offset. So 4 bits will be coming as the frame offset, and 7 bits will be coming as the frame number. So that is the cache memory address. Again, you are getting 7 and 4, 11 bits. Again, you are getting 7 and 4, 11 bits. So that is my fully associative mapping. In case of fully associative mapping, what is the advantage? The advantage here is that main memory any page can be loaded onto the cache memory, any frame. So that is the flexibility. And what is the disadvantage of fully associative mapping or associative mapping? The main disadvantage here is that CAM is a very costly hardware. Here you see, each and every CAM word has become 19 bits, not a matter of joke. So 19 bits in this particular example, 19 bits per CAM word. And CAM is a very costly memory. And each and every location of the CAM, if it occupies 19 bits, then it will be a very costly affairs and very difficult to get implemented, might not be cost effective. So that is a limitation of associative mapping. So in case of direct mapping, what is the problem? In case of direct mapping, the main problem was that if multiple pages with the same tag number wants to get loaded onto the cache memory, they cannot be loaded, either one of them. So that was the main disadvantage in direct mapping. So in case of associative mapping, what we have brought the flexibility that any page can be loaded onto the any frame. But for that, what cost we are paying? The cost is that high CAM cost, 19 bits per CAM word. In this way, CAM will be having so many words. So this is a very costly implementation. So that's why we're going to get one such mapping technique where there will be little bit flexibility and little bit constraint. And that will be there in the set associative mapping that will be coming next. So we have covered this part. That is the fully associative mapping. So please watch the next video where we will be going for the set associative mapping. Thanks for watching this one.